हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मणिवाशनी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम KIIT ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन दिल्ली NCR. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस विद यू एडिशन ऑफ वेलोसिटी थ्योरम एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ दिस थ्योरम. इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर आई वाज डिस्कस विद यू टाइम डायलेशन एंड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ टाइम डायलेशन इफेक्ट. सो हेयर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट वेलोसिटी थ्योरम फॉर relativistic particles or relativistic object which are moving with high velocity which is comparable to c. So now we are taking two frame of reference, two inertial frame of reference. One inertial frame of reference is s, which is at rest, and second inertial frame of reference is s dash, which is moving with constant velocity v with respect to s. V is high velocity. Now we are considering a particle which is moving with velocity u with respect to observer O and u dash velocity with respect to observer O dash. An observer in S measures its three velocity component to be ux is equal to dx upon dt, uy is equal to dy upon dt, and uz is equal to dz upon dt. For observer in S dash, components are ux dash is equal to dx dash upon dt dash, uy dash is equal to dy dash upon dt dash, uz dash is equal to dz dash upon dt dash. These are simple velocity equations because, as we all know, velocity is just the rate of change of displacement or position. So here x, y, z are position coordinate with respect to observer O, and x dash, y dash, z dash are the position coordinates with respect to observer O dash. So we just differentiating with respect to time, so we get velocity component. Now we want to find out the equation which relate x, y, z component of velocity with respect to observer O with the x, y, z component of velocity with respect to observer O dash. Now, as we know from Lorentz transformation, inverse transformation equation, as we know from inverse Lorentz transformation equation that x is equal to x dash plus vt dash upon under root 1 minus v square by c square, and t is equal to t dash plus vx dash upon c square divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square. Y is equal to y dash and z is equal to z dash. Now differentiating these equations, or we exactly say partially differentiating these equation, so we get dx is equal to dx dash plus vt dash upon under root 1 minus v square by c square, and dt is equal to dt dash plus v dx dash upon c square divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square, and simply dy is equal to dy dash and dz is equal to dz dash. Now dx upon dt is velocity, rate of change of position, as I said earlier. So dx upon dt, that means this equation is divided by this equation. So we get dx dash plus v dt dash upon dt dash plus v dx dash upon c square. This component will cancel out from both the equations. So now we are taking common dt dash. So dx dash upon dt dash plus v upon 1 plus v upon c square dx dash upon dt square. Dx upon dt is velocity x component with respect to observer O. So this is denoted by ux. Dx dash upon dt dash is the velocity x component with respect to observer O dash. So it is denoted by ux dash plus v 1 plus v upon c square again ux dash. So we get x component of velocity ux is equal to ux dash plus v upon 1 plus v upon c square ux dash. We want to find out the y and z component. So uy is equal to dy upon dt, which is equal to dy dash under root 1 minus v square by c square upon dt dash plus v dx dash upon c square. It is equal to uy dash under root 1 minus v square by c square divided by 1 plus v upon c square ux dash. Okay, so don't be confused, this one is y component, so here also comes y component. No, this is x component. It is simple mathematics. Again, z component is uz is equal to dz upon dt, which is equal to dz dash under root 1 minus v square by c square divided by dt dash plus v dx dash upon c square. So again we are taking dt dash common and this dt dash combined with dz dash, so we get z component of velocity, that is uz dash अंडर रूट वन माइनस वी स्क्वायर बाई सी स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई वन प्लस वी स्क्वायर बाई सी स्क्वायर यू एक्स डैश. इन जनरल वी आर टेकिंग एक्स ओनली एक्स कंपोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, दैट इज यू इज इक्वल टू यू डैश प्लस वी अपॉन वन प्लस यू डैश वी अपॉन सी स्क्वायर. सो हियर यू हैव टू सीन दैट velocity transformation equation in relativistic mechanics is completely differ from the classical mechanics. In classical mechanics, Galilean find out the velocity transformation equation that are ux is equal to ux dash plus v or ux dash is equal to ux minus v. So here the equations are completely different from the Galilean transformation equation. So these equations are known as velocity transformation equation, or it is also known as addition velocity theorem. Now what is the outcome or what is the significance of addition of velocity theorem? Though the two most important consequences or significance from the addition of velocity equation we can find out. One is consistency of Einstein's second postulate, and second is maximum velocity of light. So first I want to discuss with you first application of addition of velocity theorem is consistency of Einstein's second postulate. If you remember or if you recall, what is Einstein's second postulate? According to Einstein's second postulate, speed of light is constant in all inertial frame of reference in vacuum. So now here with the help of addition of velocity theorem, we will prove this Einstein's second postulate. So if I am taking u dash is equal to c, this one u dash is equal to c, that is light is emitted in the moving frame s dash in its direction of motion relative to s. An observer in s will measure the speed u is equal to u dash plus v1 plus u dash v upon c square. Now putting the value c plus v upon 1 plus cv upon c square, simple mathematics, we get c plus v into c upon c plus v. These two terms will cancel out with each other, so we get c. So u is equal to c. That means if light pulse is moving with velocity c with respect to s dash frame of reference, it will remain same with respect to observer s. So thus observer in s and s recorded the same value for the velocity of light. Thus the velocity of light c is the same in all inertial frames in free space. This is the second postulates of special theory of relativity. Hence we concluded that relativistic velocity addition theorem is consistent with Einstein's second postulates of special theory of relativity. Second application of addition of velocity theorem is no signal can travel faster than light in vacuum. We all are aware that more than c velocity is not possible. So now we can prove with the help of addition of velocity theorem that no signal can travel faster than light in vacuum. So now we are putting u dash is equal to c and v is equal to c. Then we get u is equal to u dash plus v upon 1 plus u dash v upon c square. Now substituting the value of u dash and v, c plus c upon 1 plus c into c is equal to c square. Again we get c. That means addition of any velocity in the velocity of light again reproduces the velocity of light. If you want, you can solve this with another value of u dash and v. If you are taking the same value of u dash and v other than c, then you never get the same value. But in case of c, it is reproduces and we get c. So hence we concluded that addition of any velocity to the velocity of light simply reproduces the velocity of light. It means that the velocity of light in vacuum is the maximum attainable velocity in nature, and no signal can travel faster than light in vacuum. So addition of velocity theorem have great importance because of these two applications. First is Einstein's second postulate, and second, no signal can travel faster than light in vacuum. So this is all about addition of velocity theorem. I will discuss with you in my upcoming lectures, variation of mass with velocity and Einstein mass energy equation. Both are very important derivations for theory of relativity. So we will meet soon in next video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay at home. Stay safe. Keep in touch. Thank you. Thank you so much.